What's good, YouTube? That one to you. Back again once again. Today we are back with episode number 9, if I'm not mistaken, of our Pokémon Conquest Let's Play here on the channel. And in the last episode, guys, we attempted to begin the invasion of Illusio over here, but Kenshin and his galley denied us a battle here, but instead they counterattacked us here in Cressalia. And we mollywopped Aya, or Anya, or whatever her name is, and her squad as well. In today's episode, we will finally be invading Illusio. They've granted us access because we have proved ourselves worthy. So if you guys are hyped for today's episode of Pokemon Conquest, and of course if you're a proud member of the Nappy Nation, make sure you smash that like button down below for us, because you already know your support is greatly appreciated. And of course, if we could break our goal of 3,500 likes, that would be absolutely amazing and insane. Your guys' support on the Let's Play so far has been mind-numbingly awesome. And I say this again, it blows me away even more, because this is not a main series Pokemon game. And 9 times out of 10, people just aren't interested. They just don't give a damn about games that are Pokemon that aren't main series. So for you guys to come through and show the support that you have on this, honestly, is just, y'all are the real MVP. That's all I'm gonna say. You guys are honestly fucking awesome. But either way, we need to get into this. A quick recap for you guys where our army and our squad's looking at right now. We have our Eevee at 210. We have Jigglypuff 202. We have Luxio, because we did have a few evolutions in the last episode. At 194, our little Nugget. At 213, we have Prinplup, who looks pissed there, but it wasn't last episode because they evolved at 191, and then Carnivine at 215. Now, before we actually invaded, I wanted to go ahead and put up a quick PSA and say a few things before we got into this. I wanted to remind you guys that what we're doing here is a Let's Play. Now, a lot of you guys offer feedback and tips and whatnot in the comment section. You know, I mentioned that before, you know, don't check the comment section if you want spoilers or anything like that. And I do read the comment section of the videos, and I do take the advice and tips that you guys offer. But the last episode, some of you guys were incredibly critical of the battle that we had. And I'm not mad, I'm not upset. Like I said, you guys offered advice and stuff like that. But I just wanted to remind you guys that we're doing a Let's Play. We're not doing a walkthrough. This isn't a Nuzlocke. It's okay if we lose. We don't have to play every single game flawlessly. It doesn't have to be a perfect move every single time. You know, that's why our LP is different than the next person's LP, because we make different moves, we make mistakes. I'm not afraid to, I'm just having fun as I play the game. And if we lose, then we try again. You know, some of you guys are just so harsh and critical in the comments section, saying, oh, you should have done this, this, and this, and you did this wrong, you did that wrong. It's like, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because, number one, we still won the battle. And it doesn't matter, number two, because if we do lose, then so what? We'll just do it again. I'm just trying to remind you guys that it's a Let's Play. It's not a walkthrough. I'm not trying to show people how to perfectly play through Conquest. And I did see you guys' comment about using the codes. If you guys don't know what to do, if you don't know what I'm talking about, you can enter codes, I think at the main menu or something like that, to get certain Pokemon to appear in different kingdoms. And still kind of sort of borderline on whether or not I want to do that. I think I'd rather just play through the game naturally, and maybe once you get to post game or a few other things, I might consider that, because like some people are offering up ideas for codes that are like not even perfect links with their partners. It's like, why would I go out of the way to get a code into the game to get a Pokemon that isn't even a perfect link? You know what I'm saying? So I don't know, I'm not too worried about it right now. My main focus for today is Illusio, so let's go ahead and jump in. Nappy Nation has arrived, we are here, we are ready to invade. Lord Nappy, Kenshin uses Psychic-type Pokemon. Bug-type and Dark-type Pokemon will be a wise choice against him, but Fighting-type and Poison-type Pokemon will probably struggle. Good thing we ain't got none of them. Select Warriors taking the battle. Alrighty then. Let's go ahead and launch them all up. This will be our first time using Luxio and Prinplup in battle, so I are hyped. I am excited. And also, you guys, did you hear today Pharrell mentioned that he's been working on Adele's new album? What? That absolutely blew my mind. You guys know I'm into music and everything, and Adele, like, you guys don't understand the vast what's the word I'm thinking of here? Variety? I don't know what word I'm thinking of here. I don't know. My iTunes library spans so many different genres. I can listen to T-Pain 1 second, K-pop the next, then Adele, then flip it back around to Earth, Wind & Fire or some other craziness. And like you guys saw in the last episode, I was singing trap. So I listen to a lot of different stuff. So for me, Adele has one of the best vocals ever. Pharrell's one of the best producers ever. So put them together, it's gonna make amazingness. So either way, I just had to mention that. Let us stake our reputation on our victory. Yeah, nigga. Now, a lot of you guys have been saying that Kenshin's Gallade is going to be an issue for us. So let's... What the hell just fell? I think I just knocked over my can of air for my PC. Okay, then. So, you came, Nappy. I sense you are not as weak as you were. I have been waiting for this moment. It is time for you to prove yourself in battle. Prove that you are worthy of being my opponent. Worthy of being? Who the fuck do you think you are? You big shit or something? Worthy of being your opponent? Yo, we are only 22 points stronger than him. This is the most balanced battle we've had yet. And this field is insane. And we have banners too. Oh my god. Oh no. The banners always make me so... We spawn on two different platforms. It's like some portal shit. Look at this. The fates shall decide the victor. There's Aya, whatever her name was. Okay, so it's basically a big circle, but it's a square at the same time. Claim all banners. All banners are claimed by the enemy or all allies are defeated. We only have 20 turns. So all you have to do is claim all the banners. We don't have to hold them for a certain number of turns. Okay, I'm going to let Jigglypuff sit back here because Jigglypuff doesn't have the best range. But I kind of sort of want to... I want to move you back here. I'm just trying to think, like, who can do the most damage and who can... We got that banner, too. Okay, so if we go through this, I'm assuming there's an orange portal somewhere else. Oh, we can go straight over here. Oh! Hello? But you see, my question now is, are they just going to all just... Well, one of them is obviously going to sit on the banner. Abra, I'm not too worried about. Dripper and Ralts. Well, the Ralts obviously need some space. So can we just go straight through here? What happens? Holy shit! We got warped! Oh, I'm afraid to send Nugget over there because there's a Drillbur. Oof! I'm gonna let him wait right here. Oh, I don't know if that was safe sending Primpup over there by himself. He's gonna get triple teamed. Well, the whatchamacallit can't attack, so he should be good. The Abra can't attack, so he should be good.
I shall show my enemies the true meaning of battle. Kanetsugu!
Yes, Lord Kenshin, our enemies shall learn the true righteousness of our cause! It's like a cult over here, what the fuck? For honor. The floating cube moves you. Are they really trying to bum rush us over here? So he's gonna take the flag because he can't attack. Okay, so they claimed a banner. Put your Gallade on there. Yeah, leave your Gallade over there, buddy. Okay, so they got two banners, we got two banners. That was a given. Oh! Please don't dig on Darumaka! Please don't dig on Dar- Oh, he can't move because he went through there. Okay, good. Go through there, too. Yeah, we about to get this banner, nigga! We about to get this banner, nigga! Oh, wait, I didn't even move Luxio or Eevee last turn! I'm a fucking idiot! Oh, my God! I thought I had moved them. Wow. I are dumb. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and hit him. And we're going to try our hardest to kill this little... Oh, it was enough, I was about to say. Now, can we do enough? Can we please do enough? Yes, we can do enough. Okay, so the Drillbur's gone. So no tricky dig. No tricky digs in this episode. That's not happening. There we go. Drillbur's down and out.
Whoa, you're just too impressive. I gotta surrender.
I mean, if you want to join the cause, buddy, I'd love to have an Excadrill any day of the week. Okay, so he can't even move onto the flag. So the Ralts can't even move onto the flag. So we're still good on this side for right now, even though we don't have anybody on our flag. My guess is he's going to go straight across here and get mollywopped over here. I kind of sort of want to get... Ooh, that's scary. Well, I don't really need someone else over here then. Never mind. Oh, Bubble Beam. Oh, wow. Like I said, this is our first time... I'd have to go here. There we go. This is our first time using either Luxio... or Prinplup, and Bubble Beam works differently than Bubble. Bubble will hit two squares, Bubble Beam also hits two squares, but you have to be two away. Yo, we have discharge. Look at the area effect of discharge. God damn. That's awesome. That is awesome. Okay, so my question is, how are we gonna move? I'm just gonna move you. Let's see where this takes us. Right here. So they can't go through that portal, right? I feel like I want to leave Eevee right here. I want to leave Eevee and Jigglypuff here. And if I can get... Because we have our forces split up basically 2-on-2-on-2. So if we can get Luxio somehow over here with Primplup. Even though, honestly, we don't even need that. Because Primplup can take care of Abra next turn. And we get that banner. So that's three banners we have. So we just have to take out this Cupchew, this Curlier, this Ralts is gone next turn. And then we can bum rush the Gallade. That was what I was saying in the last episode. Okay, we moved everybody, right? I'm pretty sure we did, yeah. That's what I was saying in the last episode. Like, some people were saying that we had to have the Starly or evolve it into a Staravia. Oh, he gets HP for being on the flag. That's fine. We have to evolve it into a Staravia or else we're going to have issues with the Gallade. It's like, why don't I just knock out everybody else and then just gang up on the Gallade? Wouldn't that work too? Their power is considerable, but they are no match for Genshin.
You seem to be enjoying yourself, brother. But you should not make light of your enemies, Genshin. If you believe you have justice on your side, you must prove it on the battlefield.
Out of my face, nigga. Can he attack? Oh, it's one square away. Ooh, what are we supposed to do? Oh, I can just send Luxio to the left, right? We have to go through the green portal to get there, though. Where? Oh, the green portal's right there. I was gonna say, where the fuck is the green portal at? What the hell?
The book? Jigglypuff, can you keep going? Right, then let's do it!
Jigglypuff hasn't done shit! Of course it can keep going! What type of question is that? Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and... Well, now my question... He can go for the flag there. I'm gonna go ahead and... hop on this flag real quick to keep him from taking the flag. And then we're gonna go over here and roll up! Roll up! Little Nugget, roll up! Little Nugget, roll up! Little Nugget, roll up! Yeah, he's gone next turn. If I would've been able to hit him with a Vine Whip, we would've done more damage. But I'm gonna move him over here so that we can slide over. And next turn, we're gonna go through that orange portal, which... Oh, wow, that takes us over here. Did the portals move? They did! The portals actually fucking move! Wow! Because I went through the blue portal to get over here. I can swear I went through the blue portal to get over to here. That's a green portal now. Wow. I are impressed. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is move up to here, and we're gonna attack this Cupchew, because even though I wanna get the Abra off that flag, Abra can't attack us. Cupchew is more of a threat right now. So I'm gonna worry about him, and wait, is the blue portal? Oh, it doesn't go over there. Fuck, we end up coming right back. I was gonna say, if the blue portal let me go over to the Primplup, that'll help him out over there. But I gotta hope and pray this portal changes so Luxio can get over here and help out Primplup. But I think we're good to end our turn. I just want to leave Eevee over here in case, because like Jigglypuff doesn't hit very hard. So it's like, even though Jigglypuff's guarding the flag, I would like Eevee to be over here to help out as well. And plus, I don't want either one of them anywhere near Gallade. Well, I'm guessing Gallade would have a Psychic-type move, since he's the ace of a Psychic-type kingdom. Oh, you're sending Curly over here? I see you, big dog. That's not going to save you. It's not going to save you next turn, I want you to know that. I want you to be very well aware that you're about to get absolutely mollywopped. It's not very effective. You can go suck a dick. How's that? How's that, little Cupchew? Cupchew was annoying as fuck in the last battle. My god, he was so annoying. Okay, so we can't actually run up on... Actually, no, I take that back. We can stay right here and run up on this Curlia instead. I was gonna say, we can't run up on the Ralts in the position that he's in. We don't have the area for that. And we get the gold. Thank you very much. So I guess for right now, I could just go here. Oh no, it's gonna hit Little Nugget! Oh! What if I go over here? No, I didn't think about that. Fuck. Oh, that makes me so sad. I don't wanna hit Nugget. I'm just gonna go through the portal. It's gonna take me up here to Gallade. And Luxio, you just stay right there. You can stay right there too. Wait, do we attack with Primplup yet? No, we did not. Yo, this little nigga right here, it's time for you to go. This Cub Chew, Aya's Cub Chew, was a pain in the ass in the last battle, and now it's a pain in the ass again. It is being a pain in the arse, and I don't appreciate it very much. Alright, we should be good to go. We should be good to go. We should be good to go. Say we should be good to go. Should be good to go. Say we should be good to go. I have confidence in this battle right now. We should be good to go. It's just gonna take a little while. Because like I said, this fucking Cub Chew is annoying as shit. I was gonna say, if you froze me, Powder Snow should not have a chance to freeze. Like what happened in the last episode. Psyshock? You're gonna Psyshock my nugget? Get off my nugget! Asshole! I can actually attack that Gallade without him being next to me. No, you're not running. He was gonna hit me with confusion. I was gonna say, you're not running. That's fine, you can confuse him. He's not moving. He's not gonna do shit. And he just gets healed every single... Why did you just move? Is it because he's confused he moved? What? Well, they both can move to take the flag. I'm going to go ahead and attack. I'm going to leave the flag open for this turn. I'm going to go ahead and attack and see what happens. Critical hit! Oh my god, get destroyed! Jesus! Alright, let me see what his move is. He has Psycho Cut, which covers two squares. So if he wants to hit me from here, he's going to have to... I don't even know if that's worth it. He's going to have to move off the flag if he wants to hit us from here. Yo, that has such a wide area of effect. It's probably why it doesn't do that much damage. But still, if he wants to hit us, he has to get off that flag. Which is what I honestly, I wouldn't mind having that because that would keep him from getting healed each turn. Yo, this is not cool. I can't even move him. Can we get the crit over here? Alright, next turn, your ass is grass. Alright, we should be good. We just had to wait it out. I'm sitting here thinking that, look at that. We did, what, 13 points of damage? And he got 12 right back? Where is the orange portal at now? Where is the orange portal at now? I want someone else over here that can do a bit more damage. So we can double team this thing. He's gonna take the flag. You piss me off so much. That confusion. The orange portal is right here in the middle. I can't get anyone over there. Okay, we're gonna move you up here. Actually, I didn't even need to do that. Take this fucking Vine Whip. I'm gonna attack with Carnivine first. Instinct? How does Instinct activate? No. I want to know what this fucking does. Show me what, you know what? I'm looking it up right now. Hold on, I'm about to sneeze too. Whew. Excuse me. Pokemon Conquest Abilities. Because we had this issue in the last episode too. I didn't know what the fuck Instinct did. Instinct, the move, the Pokemon uses intuition to swiftly evade enemy moves. But like, how often does it activate? Or is it just like a 50-50 chance? That's so aggravating. And what? Whatever. Not going to worry about it. Let's just go ahead and do what we can. Next turn, your ass is grass. That's all I'm saying. Next turn, your ass is grass. That's such horse shit. So that's what, three turns now that he hasn't been able to do anything. I mean, he's over here and able to do anything. Only thing I do is send him back through the orange portal and then hope the green portal moves again. Primplup's over here all by himself. All by myself. I don't wanna be all by myself. And look, he's just gonna heal himself up. Honestly, I think we can move Eevee off of here now. Wait, where does the green portal go to? Green portal takes me out there in the middle of fucking nowhere. Fuck it! Just go. We're stuck. We can't do anything. So we have to wait for the portal to change.
I don't know what's smarter. Should I keep attacking the Kupchu? Or should I attack the Abra and sit on the flag? I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna attack the Abra and sit on the flag so it heals me. Because the Abra... Oh, the Abra's got instinct too! How fucking perfect! Amazing! Next turn, I'll probably end up using Sweet Song. Fucking hell, come on! We're just all over the place in this map. We can't even do enough damage. Well, at least the Curlia can't attack us. That's the plus side of it sitting on the flag like that. I guess. That's the plus side. So you want to stay there? So now both... Oh no, the Kupchu won't get hit. The Kupchu won't get hit. That's the downside to being over there. And now the Eevee can go through the blue portal. Which takes us over here, which is no... Does the orange? Orange takes me over here. Oh! Let's do this. Oh wait, is this smart? It's not smart. Well, actually, it could be. So I can sit right here and get the job done quicker over here. Okay. Since we're not doing anything with the Gallade over here, we're gonna go with the original plan of sending Luxio over here to help out Primplup. Because I can send Luxio right here, and Discharge should be able to hit both of them and not Primplup. And we should be good. We should be good, we should be good. So next turn, this flag should be cleared. We're not gonna have a mod on it next turn, but next turn the flag should be cleared. And we'll be good. And I think... Well, there's Curlia. Honestly, we can actually get Jigglypuff off this flag now. If we really wanted to. I mean, Jigglypuff can't go anywhere right now because... Green Portal's just gonna send it right back. But we can actually get Jigglypuff off because I remember from the Green Leaf situation, you don't have to sit on the flag. If you do sit on the flag, it gets you more HP back, but you don't have to sit on the flag. Alright, we're gonna do this. We're gonna do this. And next turn, we'll heal Jigglypuff. I know I said last turn we're gonna heal this turn, but next turn we're gonna heal Jigglypuff. So, little Nugget here is gonna have to take a hit from Carnivine. Here we go. And you burn too! Oh! Oh, how does that make you feel? How'd that make you feel though? Bop! Nice and crit! Get out of here, stupid ass. Okay, so I'm gonna take Eevee. Oh, Eevee can't move. Eevee already moved. Never mind. So the only one that we have... No, wait. Who's the only one that hasn't moved? Is it just Jigglypuff? Yeah, it's just Jigglypuff. You can see on the top screen. Actually, no, I could heal this turn, actually. Let's go ahead and do it. Let's go ahead and heal. Let's go ahead and heal, because why not? And we can, end our turn. End our turn, just like that. I think some people were saying that we should replace Jigglypuff with Gible. Remember I was talking about using the codes? We should use a code to get Gible and replace Oichi's Jigglypuff with that. But the only Pokemon that Oichi gets 100% link with is Wigglytuff. So, it's like, do we use codes to get other Pokemon, or do we go for 100% links? Now you attacking the Luxray? Nigga, what? Oh, you want to disappear. I guess you figured it's time to retreat. Guess you figured it's smarter to retreat. Alright, so Carnivine, you can chill out there. You can chill out there. I think Kyo and Carnivine, this is as high as their link goes, 38%. So they're not going to get any closer. So whatever Kyo's... I looked it up last time. What is her perfect link? I'll look it up after the episode. So this little green portal takes us back over here. So I'm not really going to worry about that all too much right now. We do still have 13 turns left. And I think within 13 turns, if we can get as many mons over to the other side as we can, that would be the best thing. So what I'm going to do right now is we are... Wait, where does the blue portal take me? Blue portal takes me into the middle of the field. Shit. I'm going to move here so that I can... It doesn't matter. I can move next turn. I was going to say, so I can do this and attack the Abra, but... And we got Paralysis. But I was going to say, I can't move Primplup because Primplup has to stay here so he can hit it. So it wouldn't make a difference if I sat there or right in front of the Abra. Get out. Get to stepping. Out my face. Out my face. Nobody cares. So everybody's moved but Jigglypuff again. There's only two enemies left. We have the Kupchu and the Gallade, but we're in the middle of the fucking field here. We can't even get over... That's stupid. That right there, that is stupid. We can't even get over to their fucking field. Do the portals only change when... Oh, never mind. I answered my question. And now the only one that can go over there is Jigglypuff. Okay! Where's the blue portal at? Oh, blue portal's right here. I might have a chance. Actually, I'm gonna leave Luxio right here. I'm gonna leave Luxio here to claim this banner. Oh, I can't go over. Fuck! I can't go through the portal as it is, so I might as well just get the gold. Might as well get the gold. I was gonna say, we can go through the blue portal, we can end up over here, slide down here, next turn go through the green portal, get over to here. This is gonna be the end of us right here, trying to deal with these fucking portals. Because we can't go anywhere. I'm gonna risk it with Eevee. I'm gonna risk it with Eevee. I'm gonna risk it with Nugget too. Fuck it. Fuck it! I'm on my YOLO status right now. Whatever happens, happens. Wherever they end up going, they end up going. And you know what? I'm gonna send Jigglypuff. Oh, this is not a good idea. It's not a good idea to do that. Because I already know if I send Jigglypuff over to here, next turn little cup, she's gonna slide right back over to here. Or do the portals change? Well, I can't even go through the portal this turn, so it doesn't make a difference. It doesn't make a difference. I was gonna say the portals change each turn, but it doesn't make a difference. Or do they only change when they're used? And he went through, and over here he comes. What the fuck did I tell you was gonna happen? What did I tell you was gonna happen? But this is actually not bad, because now we can get little Prinplup over here to the Gallade. There we go. There we go. And we can get, oh my god, yes, let's go. We can get two Mons over there. We did abandon that flag, which is risky, which is what I did not want to do. Oh no, why did they put him out right there? He's about to get Psycho Cut it to all fucking back. I guess we just did that just to clear him off the portal. Maybe with him sitting on the portal, it won't change. But where's the green? Green portal's in the middle. Fuck. Jigglypuff, you're gonna have to hold it down, girl. Actually, you know what? No, I'm not even gonna wait. I'm not even gonna wait. Because he's not gonna run up on us. No matter what, he's not gonna run up on us. That's the thing. Because Powder Snow is two squares, so he doesn't have to run up on us. So he can sit there and just keep hitting Jigglypuff over and over and over again to no avail. So we're gonna go ahead and leave this for now and see what ends up happening. Oh, does the square keep changing? The fuck? Oh, he does run right up on us like that. Ooh, I see you, big dog. Oh, no! Ah! Oh, my God, a critical hit! Leave him alone! Oh, my God, I knew it was gonna hurt. And the orange portal's in the middle of the fucking field! Oh, my God. I should have sent someone through there to move the block over. I'm gonna go back on here. Where does the blue turtle... Blue turtle. Where's the blue turtle take me? Blue portal takes me over to here. You know what? Fuck it, YOLO. We're gonna send little Nugget over here to deal with his ice type. Fuck with a real nigga real quick. Alright, so I'm gonna move you. No. I'm gonna move you right to there so that we can keep discharging. So that means that we should be able to hit him, paralyze him. That counters the HP he's gonna get back in between the next turns, and I should be able to sit right here and attack him, and he can't hit me with his Psycho Cut because I'm more than two squares away. There we go. So if he wants to take out the Luxio, he's gonna have to move off that flag. And when he does, Piplup's gonna come through. Green portal's right there. You know what? I'm gonna move you off so the thing doesn't move. The little block doesn't move. Okay. This is like a big game of chess on this fucking field. Full heal? Okay. Big dog, I see you. He's not moving off there. You know what? You keep attacking my bulbous Mons. And another bulbous Mon is gonna come fuck you up, okay? Jigglypuff and Darumaka are like my testicles. I'm an idiot sometimes, I swear. 134 Nugget, come through! Buddy, bitch! That annoying little cup, you can suck a dick and just die! God, go the fuck away! Go ahead, scoop that up. Alright, so the only Mon left is the Gallade. We have two Mons over here already attacking it. Where's the blue portal at? Oh, fuck, it's all the way over here. Well, I mean, if we can get a little Nugget over there, that would be nice. for us to attack him. I mean, he would just get hit with, whatchamacallit, over and over and over again. He would just get hit with, what is it called? Psycho Cuts over and over and over and over. Over and over again! I try and tell myself that we could never be more than friends. We don't have potions. Oh, I gotta go back to the shop and heal everybody up. Alright, so we have a strategic placement over here. That counters that, and we got a paralysis too. I was gonna say, that's a chance to paralyze, and it counters the HP he gets back from sitting on the flag. And it sucks that we're fighting him head on, because I know we get more damage from the side and whatnot. Actually, no, I could just move. No, I can't. I was gonna say, I could just move over to here. But I can't, because then he'd be sitting there and get hit with discharge. Well, that sucks. So we have basically 8 turns left to take down this Gallade, so we're not getting a Warlord this turn. We are not getting a Warlord this turn. Okay, I'm just gonna... Wait, where's the blue portal? Green portal's right there. Where's the green portal? Oh, shit. Green portal's right here. Oh, you can't reach it! Fuck! That's so aggravating. You can't even reach the green portal. Ooh, I could have him over here. He'd have to stand to the... No, he wouldn't have to stand to the side. I could actually put, what's his name right here? Carnivine right here. And Vinewood would hit the 3 squares across. So we'd have 3 Mons going up against it, which would be nice, because that would be, what, like 50 damage each turn? He'd be gone in just a matter of a few turns. I mean, he's going to be gone in a matter of a few turns anyway. And I'm just going to send Eevee over here just for GP, because why the fuck not? And where's the orange portal going this time? Right there in the middle. Okay, then! Alrighty then, that's you just little nugget, you could just chill. I'm gonna send you right here so that you can chill right next to the portal, so in case it opens up, we're good to go. And you're paralyzed, so basically now it's just a waiting game. That's all it is now, because his galley is the only thing that's left. And I told you guys this is how it was gonna go down, right here, just like this. Okay, so green portal is still there. Green portal for a green mon. Green portal for a green Pokemon. And he's already in position too. Next turn, about to be the most fire turn ever! I wonder if we can actually kill this Gallade next turn. I wonder. Because I feel like Vine Whip's going to do like 12 points of damage too. So if we do on average 12 points, 12 times 3 is 36. And that is not enough. He won't die next turn. He will not be dying next turn. Okay. So everybody else is where they need to be. Everyone else is in basically in position. So this battle is just a waiting game. Oh, and the HP comes back. I was gonna say, this battle is just a waiting game at this point. Can we get anyone else over here? Orange portals connect there. There's a blue portal in the middle of the field. Nope, can't get them over there. Alright, so we're here now. Actually, I could just stay facing that way. It's only just 8 points of damage. Didn't even do 12. Gallade, there's no reason for you to be this strong. No reason for your defenses to be like this, okay? There's a bird. Holy shit. God damn, I just saw out of the corner of my eye something on my fucking window, and on the screen outside the window, this bird just lands. It's little talons in the fucking wall, this little Talo looking thing. And I'm like, okay, I didn't realize my screen was that interesting. Oh my god. Okay, so again, there's nothing we can do here, so it's just a waiting game. Because Eevee, Darumaka, and whatchamacallit, and he's back! The bird is back! Get off my screen! Don't be making no nests outside of my house! Okay? You got cactuses in the desert. He's climbing the screen now. Can you... There's 2 birds! Yo, I'm gonna show you guys these birds. Oh my god, my monitor just went dark. As soon as I grab the webcam, they leave. Oh, you son of a bitch. Don't be climbing on my goddamn windowsill if you don't want to be on the video. I'm telling you, they just, like, 2 of them just on the side of my fucking window screen like that. Okay, whatever. Whatever. They come back, we about to film them real quick. Film they ass real quick, like. Okay, so let's see. Do we have orange portal over here? The green portals have not moved. Okay, portals have not moved. So, we're still here playing the waiting game. Just saw a bird fly by. I feel like that's gonna be an issue over the next couple weeks. One of them little niggas is gonna make a nest in a vent or some shit outside, and it's gonna be a pain in the ass trying to get him out.
We're so close now. It's just a waiting game. Like, can he wait out 5 turns? It's like the TCG. It's like, oh my god. How many they're gonna stall me out and make me deck out here? Alright. Kenshin. I mean, the psychic deck was like this in TCG too. Just so fucking stall heavy. Because he's not even moving. He can't move. I can't move anyone over there either. That'll make it even easier. God, I want to move Eevee to this side. They're back. Oh, fuck, they just took off again. Stop it! Fucking Talos on the window. Over here, I'm gonna move Eevee over here on the off chance that one of these portals, one of these two portals over here, because you see, like, this green one's open up to go over here right now. Alright, can we get enough damage? Can we get enough damage? Parry. Stop with these abilities that just make shit miss! Come on now! That's such horse shit. 14, yeah. Nice and max roll. Now can we get 17 damage? Oh my god! Urgh! Ah! Come on! I'm sure there's somebody watching right now that has a superior strategy than the one I'm using. And they're watching and screaming at their screen right now and typing furiously in the comment section in all caps, because everyone knows if you use caps that helps the person see your comment better. And looky here, looky what I found. Finally, Eevee can go ahead and move over. Oh wait, Eevee's gonna get hit by a bubble bee. And a discharge. I should have waited. Fuck, I should have waited before I did that. Whoops, I didn't know it was gonna plop him off right there. I mean, it could have put him out right here. That would have been nicer. Alright, we're gonna see. It's gonna do more damage to Eevee. I'm sorry, Eevee. I apologize. I really do. Oh, and of course it was a crit on the Eevee. Couldn't have got a crit on the Gallade this whole time. No, get a crit on the Eevee. Fate is not on our side. Oh, yeah. Now, you, oh, we still have to claim all the banners. Well, Luxio, good thing you can move over here, nigga. Go ahead, Fohead. Didn't get the last goal, but oh well. Defeat is simply inconceivable. Yeah. Yeah. Victory. I will take it. I will gladly accept that victory. Alright! So we got our links up. Which I am happy about. I'm very happy about. Look at those links rising. Look at everybody over 200. Like I said, Carnivine and Kyo are at their maximum link. So until we find someone else that's on the field that's a bit better, someone else we can recruit that's a bit better to hold their spot on the team, Kyo just gonna rock out with a little 38% link. So. Oh well. Oh well. Oh well, oh well, oh well. Why can he be recruited? I said in the battle that we weren't going to recruit him because we didn't do it in 4 turns. We didn't beat him in 4 turns, we didn't hit him with a super effective move, we didn't beat him with a Warlord. Chikamasa and his Primplup beat him, so why can Kenshin now be recruited?
Very impressive, Nappy. I am forced to acknowledge your talents on the battlefield. Under your command, Nappy, my might will be of use in bringing righteousness to this world. And you, Nemesis, I know you are there. Show yourself. I thought you might spot me there!
Why big nigga here now with this Rhyperior?
I watched your battle against Kenshin, Nappy, and it confirmed what I've been feeling for a while. I, too, want to join your army. My nemesis and I united at last. I never thought I'd see the day! Neither did I.
My goodness, you look happy, Kenshin.
Lord Kenshin and Lord Shingen are among the most powerful warlords in all Ransai. To have them both fighting for your army is quite a coup, Lord Nappy. So, is that like some storyline shit? Is that what happened just now? Because we didn't fulfill the regular requirements, and now both him and the other guy with the Rhyperior both want to be on our team. I feel like that was some storyline bullshit right there. But we did get the Drillbur. We knocked him out real quick. Recruit Kenshin and others? Yes, please. And look, I just said, once we get someone better for the Carnivine, we'll swap them out.
I'll respond to your favor on the field of battle.
You have reached the maximum permitted number of warriors in this kingdom. Alright, where are we going to deploy Kenshin?
Wait, we haven't taken on Terrier yet? I thought he said he wanted to join us.
And why does this building look like Groudon?
I guess, go to Pugilus.
You go to Pugilus too. You go to Pugilus. Everybody go to Pugilus. Pugilus in this motherfucker right here. Kenshin's army has been defeated and has been forced to retreat.
Yeah.
It looks like we're heading for an all-out war with Nobunaga for control of Ransai.
Indeed, we will face battles more difficult than any we have ever experienced before.
Yeah, but before all of that, I've made us something to eat. Go ahead and enjoy.
Ah, this does look tasty. How considerate of you. Very well, let's have ourselves a little feast and celebration, shall we?
Oh, look at all these happy-ass niggas. Knowing that a showdown with Nobunaga was not far away, Nappy's army resolved to take this fleeting moment to relax and enjoy themselves. Their merriment did not last long, however.
This nigga has a Zekrom! Why is he so badass?
Look at the black and gold and the purple. Look, I told y'all with the chair. Black, gold, purple. Black, gold, purple. I said black, gold, purple. I don't even know what voice to do for Nobunaga. He's like too perfect. Like, what am I supposed to do for Nobunaga?
The short life of a man.
I can't. No, that doesn't fit him. That doesn't fit him. What voice am I supposed to do for Nobunaga?
The short life of a man is nothing compared to the age of this world. It is but a fleeting dream, an illusion.
Brother?
What is it that you desire?
I desire Lord Nappy to find the legendary Pokémon and bring peace to Ransai.
How amusing. I should like to see you try and make that wish come true. Defeat my subordinates and we shall see.
Nobunaga will be waiting for you in Dragnor. I feel like some colossal storyline shit just went down.
Lord Nappy, I'm sorry I didn't say anything before, but Nobunaga is my brother. That's how I know that he's serious. We have to stop him, Lord Nappy. He'll destroy Ransai if we don't.
That's just the one minuscule, colossal detail you could have mentioned before. Fuck!
We can't let that happen. That's why I decided to join you, Lord Nappy. I know it's going to be tough, but we must battle against the warriors of Nobunaga's army. We'll start with Avia, Viperia, Cragspur, and Yaksha. We can proceed no further until we're able to conquer those four kingdoms. I know I'm not strong, Lord Nappy, but I will give all my all for this cause.
You ain't lying. You ain't that strong. Shit. The battle has been won. Say yes, please. Save the goddamn progress. Save it up. Save it up right now. Right now. So what is going on with here? Okay, so the rest of his army is gone. So we did actually recruit Homeboy here in his Rhyperior. So I have a feeling that if we would have chosen to take on Terrera, the same would have happened for Illusio. Like, Kenshin would have ended up joining our army, which I guess is kind of a cool storyline. It, like, gives you two different options. But, like I said, I feel like a huge storyline thing just happened, especially since this is, like, a choke point in the region. So, I don't know. I kind of wish that we would have taken on Terrera, because that was a tougher challenge. That would have been more interesting to see. I don't know, but Illusio was still one hell of a chess game, so I'm not mad about that either. So, we now have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 kingdoms under our control, and we have 4 more here. Oh my god. Yaksha, which looks like a dark-type kingdom. Cragspur, which is a rock-type kingdom, I'm guessing. Viperia, which looks like a poison-type kingdom. And then Avia, which looks electric to me. Oh my god, look at their... Oh, he's 1300. I was gonna say, look at their levels. 1500, 1300. Our army... I'm gonna go ahead and move on to the next month right now. Advance to the next month. I think what we're going to do is, because we don't have any fighting or psychic type mons on our team. Oh, we recruited someone. Yeah. Add him up. Terremoto. Add him up. Terremoto. There we go. So he's added to there. So
So we have them searching, we have them training. You're now able to challenge the warlords of Avia, Viperia, Kragspur, and Yaksha to battle. Ooh, not just yet. Hold on. So we got four there. We have nobody in Cresselia. I might do some off-screen stuff to check out and see previous warlords in these kingdoms. But all I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go ahead, like I said, Kyo, her match up with, or her link with, whatchamacallit, Carnivine, is Dunzo for now. So I'm going to go ahead and march her. I'm going to march her back to Cresselia. No, I'm going to march her to Violite. And I might end up doing some off-screen recruiting and not necessarily grinding with our army, because I don't want our army to become too OP. See, my thing is, do I scoop up, because I think our next one's going to be Kragspur. I feel like I should scoop up Rhyperior for the next battle over Gallade. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Obviously, we just scooped up two warlords. Let me know what you think we should add to the team. Either Kenshin or, what's his name? What is his name? I don't know what his name is. Shingen, I think he said his name is. Either Kenshin or Shingen, let us know who you think we should add to our team as our new sixth member. And I guess the next episode we're going to be taking on Kragspur, which is the Rock-type kingdom, because Avia is a bit too strong. They got 700 points on us. And then these two will be after that. So let us know in the comment section below, either Shingen or Kenshin, who should we add? And of course, if you guys enjoyed today's extra long episode of Conquest, and if you're a proud member of the Nappy Nation and like to help us break our goal of powerful 3,500 likes on today's episode, make sure you smash that like button down below for us. And please don't forget, this series runs Monday through Friday, so the next episode will be the following Monday. We won't have any Conquest this weekend. I got some stuff to do this weekend around the house as well, so I'm kind of relieved. Less stress for me, because not that I don't like recording Conquest, it's just I got stuff to do. That's all I'm trying to say. Anyways, thank you guys so much for your support, and thank you for checking out the video. Get on me, TheKingNappy. I'm out.